Hi, pal, what you doing?
I'm Tempest from Mars.
Yeah, what's his butt? Say, you weren't thinking of flying, were you?
Well,
you know Andy loves toys that can fly.
Really? Well then, to infinity and beyond!
You know, Andy loves toys that he can find.
This is a test that was animated by Andrew Stanton. He can tell his design has gone through a couple changes. His body is scaled differently. He's got a totally different face. Notice he's got two holsters. This was a test that was animated back before Tom Hanks had signed. We were trying to convince Tom to throw his hat in the ring with us. And apparently he liked it.
Oh, no, you're eating the car! Don't eat the car! Not the car! Oh, you stupid fuck!
This is another test that Andrew Stanton did. Quick draw. Nice. And again, it's physically believable, good weight shifts, but it also tells you a lot about Woody's character. It really communicates a lot about who Woody is. This is a test that was animated by Pete Docter, and this was a preliminary version of Buzz. You see his face is kind of similar, but his body is much smaller than the original Buzz. The color's different, the helmet's different, he's got funny wings. The runs that Pete's doing here are probably different than they would be if he had been using the new Buzz, the Buzz we're all familiar with. This is a test that John Lasseter animated. How about that? That doesn't happen too often. And again, this is just a character study of Buzz. At one point, they were wondering, you know, what would it be like if Billy Crystal did the voice of Buzz. So they grabbed a line from a Billy Crystal movie and animated this test. Looks great.
Right now, everything is great. Everyone is happy. Everyone is in love. And that's wonderful. But you got to know that someday, believe it or not, you'll go 15 rounds over who's going to get this coffee table. This stupid wagon wheel Roy Rogers garage sale coffee table.
I thought you liked it.
I was being nice!
Woody!
Ah, ah.
I'd just like to wish you luck. I know you'd do the same for me.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah, there you go. Yeah.
Whoa! Ho!
What? What are you... What's everybody looking at? What? Hey, he slipped. I tried to... I couldn't hold that. It was an act. He slipped.
Hey, I don't see him. I think he fell onto the street.
Well, he was as good as roadkill.
He ain't going to pizza now.
Woody, you deliberately threw Buzz out the window.
Hey, it's a toy world.
Cowboy, where is your honor, dirtbag? You are an absolute disgrace. You don't deserve to wear a 10-gallon hat on your pint-sized head.
Men, search and rescue. I want a medevac team on the double. Hustle up. Move it.
Hey, Spuds for brains. What do you think you're doing? Off the bed. Hey, off the bed!
You gonna make us, Woody?
No, he is. Slinky! Slinky! Get up here and do your job! Are you deaf? I said take care of them!
I'm sorry, Woody, but I have to agree with them. I don't think what you did was right.
What? Am I hearing correctly? You don't think I was right? Who said your job was to think, Spring Wiener?
Well, I just thought
that you... Just use this vast reserve of brain power to consider this for a moment. If it wasn't for me, Andy wouldn't pay any attention to you at all. In fact, my stretchy friend, you would have been hauled away to Goodwill a long time ago, so shut your mouth and get them off the bed. Do it. now, Slink, or I'm throwing you off.
You're going to have to throw the two of us off.
Make that three.
Count me in.
No, Woody. You get your butt off the bed.
I don't believe this. Are you threatening me?
Yeah. Get off the bed, ranch hand, and we're throwing you off.
You and what army?
Here he is, that dirtbag! Frag him! Move, move, move! Take no prisoners! Go for him! Go for the throat! Kill! Kill! Kill!
One! Two!
Stop! Don't throw him off the bed!
Yeah!
Throw him out the window like he did to Bud!
Before I was one of the co-directors of Toy Story 2, I was actually one of the editors of the original Toy Story movie. One of the most difficult decisions that an editor ever has to make, especially on one of our films here at Pixar, is cutting out animation that's already been completed. Because the animation is so expensive and time-consuming, and the animators really just pour their hearts into a lot of this stuff, we really try not to cut any of it out of the film. But unfortunately, occasionally we do need to. The first scene is a scene with Sid, right after Pizza Planet, when Sid has first brought Buzz and Woody back to his house. And the way we originally conceived the scene, we had this whole thing where Sid was torturing Buzz and Woody really pretty violently. And we ultimately decided to just cut into the scene right when Sid is interrogating and to remove all the kind of torturing stuff at the beginning. And the main reason we did that was we realized that our audience was going to be loving Buzz and Woody at this point, and the last thing they really wanted to see was them getting completely beaten up and tortured. The other scene that we didn't really cut out of the movie, but we shortened quite a bit, was the scene at night in Sid's bedroom when it's raining and Woody is trapped under the milk crate and trying to get Buzz's attention. The scene was originally much longer than what's in the final film. And at the time that we made the cuts, we made them because we were worried that the scene was playing too long and was just kind of losing the energy of the movie. Now that it's a few years later, looking back, we actually kind of regret that we made a lot of the cuts because we think that it was a really effective emotional scene and it probably could have stood up in the film as is. But you can decide for yourself when you watch the scene.
G-forces now!
Mayday! Mayday! He's breaking off! He's breaking off!
Oh, a survivor! Where's the rebel base? Talk!
I'd like to join your posse, boys, but first I'm gonna sing a little song.
Liar!
I can see your will is strong. Well, we have ways of making you talk.
Over here and see if you can get this toolbox off me. What? What are you looking at me like that for? Hey, I didn't do anything. You're the one who wouldn't hide, Buzz. It's your own fault that you're strapped to that thing.
I want to ride the pony.
All right, I'm sorry, okay? Is that what you want to hear, Buzz? I shouldn't have left you out there for Sid. There, I said it, but you gotta admit, you weren't helping me much. Oh, come on, Buzz, I can't do this without you.
In the development of our films, especially Toy Story, we go down a lot of wrong paths.
A lot.
We develop the stories that we think are absolutely perfect. These sequences are just genius. We look at them on the script, great. We storyboard them, they're fantastic. Yeah. We look at them on a story reel, they stink. We're gonna show you these abandoned sequences, or more appropriately, our mistakes. And there's a lot of really great ones here that we really love. The Buzz Lightyear cartoon, there's an alternate opening for Toy Story where it's more of a fantasy sequence of Andy's. There's a great Woody's Nightmare, which is actually something that ended up in Toy Story 2. And there's that one sequence that you always talked about that actually, in a weird way, became the theme of Toy Story 2, a little sequence starring Shakes the Rattle.
Yeah, we had this whole character named Shakes the Rattle, who was one of Andy's baby toys, and all the toys kind of gathered around and heard the story about what happened to Shakes the Rattle, because he was abandoned and lost, and lo and behold, that ended up becoming the whole central theme of Toy Story 2.
Yep.
Yeah. So here is a bunch of our mistakes.
I've won! In less than a minute, that planet of orphans will be destroyed. And after you have witnessed my glorious triumph, you will die, Buzz Lightyear!
Not today, Zurg.
He's broken through the indestructible bonds! Bongo, my faithful robot slave, kill Buzz Lightyear! Bongo, fire atomic bases! Bongo! Buzz Lightyear!
Exciting episode of Buzz Lightyear, Defender of the Universe.
Wow, Buzz Lightyear! What a cool show!
You must die, Buzz Lightyear.
Not today, Zurg!
You're the fastest gun in the West. Well, let's just see how fast you are, Sheriff. Drop!
good slime wander. Ah, ooh, ah, I'm dying, you got me. Ah, ugh. Good shooting, Woody.
You're my favorite deputy. Buzz Lightyear to the rescue. Buzz Lightyear to the rescue. Buzz Lightyear to the rescue.
Woody, Buzz glows in the dark. Isn't he cool?
Do you glow in the dark, Woody?
Hey, yeah. Let's see if Woody glows. Hey, Woody, you don't glow. I don't think I like you anymore.
Hiya! Oh, Woody, you shouldn't sneak up on a superhero like that, cowboy. You could get hurt. Now, that's a safety tip. Now, go back to sleep.
No. Buzz. There's a problem.
A problem?
Yes.
The sun!
No, not...
The sun has been kidnapped! Children can't play! You'll never get up in the morning! No more breakfast!
Oh, Buzz!
The sun is gone!
Buzz, the sun being gone is not the problem. Buzz, it's nighttime!
I see.
Look, the problem is this.
You know, Woody, I think I've been accepted into your culture.
Great.
Your chief, Andy, inscribed his name on me.
What?
Juvenile, but endearing.
And that's the problem!
My foot.
No! No, Buzz. Andy. Andy is in grave danger. That's why I'm so glad that you are here. Really. Truly, Buzz. If you were here, I can't... How can I... Oh, Buzz. Oh, Buzz, my friend.
Get a hold of yourself, cowboy.
Oh, Buzz, I'm not a cowboy. I'm just dressed like one. You see, it's my cover. I was sent here to help you on your mission.
My mission?
Yes. And I know also that we are the only thing standing between Andy and certain... Well, I...
What?
You
what?
Don't,
what?
No,
what?
I can't...
What can we do?
All right. Follow me.
This is your station, Buzz. We call it the Eastern Gate. It's the weak point of our defensive network. Your job is to not let those villainous scum get through to Andy.
Andy! He's been left unguarded!
No, it hasn't! He's fine! Buzz, come back! Buzz, come back! Heal, Buzz, heal!
Don't worry, Andy. No one gets by Buzz Lightyear.
It's Sid.
My mom's gonna blow.
What's a Sid?
Carl! Carl, run, Carl!
Hit the dirt!
My mom's about to...
That is a Sid!
Give her back, Sid.
Scott, over here.
Give her back, Sid, please.
Here,
Phillips,
go
is
on,
just
Scott.
Downright evil.
I'm going to have to teach that young man a lesson.
Absolutely, Buzz. Why don't you melt him with your scary laser?
Keep away. You keep away from Sid Phillips. You all are too young to remember Shakes.
Shakes?
The rattle?
The best damn rattle I ever worked with. Till Sid got a hold of him. I took old Shakes into that room of his, and I never seen him again. But I heard. I heard the screams.
You mean like happy screams, right?
Some say he pulled Shakes apart, like the wings off a fly. There's others that think he melted him in acid, a bit at a time. Pulled his eyes out first to let him watch. But I say Shakes was lucky. In Sid's room, there's things much worse than death. Aye, Shakes was lucky.
Ooh, scary.
Woody, hang on, Buzz. I'm coming.
Woody, look out. Sid is in the...
Houston! All systems are go. Do we have permission to launch?
Roger. We are confirmed. At T-minus 10 seconds and counting. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ignition. Huh?
Geppetto, look! I'm a real boy!
Matches? What are you, 7? 8?
You shouldn't be playing with these. I think it's time we had a talk.
But you're probably
thinking,
but toys can't move!
And we don't usually move in front of people. In fact, it's never been done.
But you are such a...
Vicious.
Yeah, vicious. And stupid.
Selfish.
Nasty,
repulsive little butt face.
That we made an exception just for you.
Please don't hurt me.
Hurt you?
Please don't.
We don't want to hurt you.
I do.
Now, Buzz. All we want is to clear up a few things. Guys. We're tired of being kicked around. We're tired of being blown up, pulled apart, burned, and broken. So we're going to be watching you, Sid. Yes, sir, all the time. You can't get away from us, kiddo. Your toys can see everything. So play nice.
The toys! The toys are alive! Help me, they're alive! They don't like me. Help, the toys are alive!
I'm kind of new at this toy thing, but something tells me we aren't supposed to do that.
Oh, what harm could it have done, Buzz? Just screwed him up for the rest of his life, that's all.
No! No! I'm sorry! I'm sorry! Oh, no! I'll never hurt you again! No! Mom!
Toss him overboard!
It's Buzz!
He's alive! And Woody's helping him in that wonderful...
Great, now I have Gil. Come on! We've got to help him up on the truck!
We're getting closer!
Don't they feed this animal?
Was our ticket home?
Not quite.
Now let's all be nice and say hello to our new friend.
Buzz Lightyear mission log, stardate 4072. I've landed on a strange planet.
Terrain seems a bit unstable. No readout yet as to whether the air is breathable.
My ship! Damn. This'll take weeks to repair.
It looks as though I might be here a while.
And there seems to be no sign of intelligent life anywhere.
Hello?
Oh, yeah!
Whoa! Didn't mean to frighten you there, pal.
Howdy. Welcome to Andy's room. I'm Woody. And, well, this is a bit awkward, but you see, there's been a bit of a mistake. This bed is my spot.
Local and, law enforcement. It's about time you got here. I'm Buzz Lightyear, Space Ranger, Universe Protection Unit. All right, fill me in here. Where's the danger?
Danger?
I must have been sent to this planet because of some danger or catastrophe. Catastrophes are my forte.
Well, we're fresh out of catastrophes. But, you know, the closet is a mess.
Now, about the bed.
Watch yourself. Halt! Who goes there?
Don't shoot!
It's okay.
Friends.
Do you know these life forms?
Yes. They're Andy's toys.
All right, everyone. You're clear to come up.
They must have handled this guy awfully rough in shipping.
I am Buzz Lightyear. I come in peace.
Oh, I'm so glad you're not a dinosaur.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Now, thank you all for your kind welcome.
Say, what's that button do?
I'll show you. Buzz Lightyear to the rescue!
Wow!
Hey, well, Woody's got something like that. His is a pull string, only...
Only it sounds like a car ran over it.
Oh, yeah, not like this one. This is a quality sound system. Probably all copper wiring, huh? So, where are you from? Singapore? Hong Kong?
I'm stationed in the Gamma Quadrant of Sector 4.
Oh, really? I'm from Play School.
And I'm from Mattel. Well, I'm not really from Mattel. I'm actually from a smaller company that was purchased in a leveraged buyout. Well, I don't really understand
the
financials.
I'll bet he glows in the dark. Excuse me, handsome, but what would happen if I push that big button of yours?
Please, be careful. You don't want to be in the way when my laser goes off.
Don't I?
Hey, a laser! How come you don't have a laser, Woody?
It's not a laser. It's a little light bulb that blinks.
What's with him?
Laser envy.
All right, that's enough. Look, we're all very impressed with Andy's new toy.
Toy?
T-O-Y. Toy.
Excuse me. I think the word you're searching for is Space Ranger.
The word I'm searching for, I can't say because there's preschool toys present.
Getting kind of tense, aren't you?
Oh, Mr. Lightyear, now I'm curious. What does a Space Ranger actually do?
He's not a Space Ranger! He doesn't fight evil or shoot lasers or fly!
Excuse me.
Oh, impressive wingspan! Very good.
Oh, what? What? These are plastic. He can't fly.
They are a pterillium carbonic alloy, and I can fly.
No, you can't.
Yes,
I can't.
You can't.
Can.
Can't. Can't. Can't.
Can. Hey, this is getting good.
And I tell you, I can fly around this room with my eyes closed.
Okay, then, Mr. Lightbeer, prove it.
All right, then I will. Stand back, everyone.
You guys better get ready to clean up the wreckage.
To infinity and beyond!
Woohoo!
Whoa! 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 Can.
This is Andy's room. That's all I wanted to say.
All right, that's enough. Look, we're all very impressed with Andy's new toy.
Toy?
Excuse me, I think the word you're searching for is Space Ranger.
Buzz! Buzz!
Doesn't he realize that I'm not there?
I'm lost! Oh, the lost toy!
We're here, and you just tell the nice toys that you're not dead.
Buzz, Buzz Lightyear, you are not worried, are you?
Me? No, 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 no.
Large box. It's.
Are you?
Now, Buzz, what could Andy possibly get that is worse than you?
Oh, what is it? What is it? Wow, a puppy!
This is Andy's room, the late afternoon, and it's after Buzz Lightyear has gotten here, so you can see kind of the Buzz posters and the Buzz Lightyear comforter on Andy's bed. And if you look very carefully at the book titles, if you've seen some of the other Pixar short films, you'll probably recognize a few of the names. If not the title of the film itself, then certainly if you look at the credits, you'll see other people's names on there. One thing it was really hard to do when we started this was try and find a way to caricature the world and shapes in the world. The one thing about lighting and texturing that we do here is it really does bring it back more into a really believable world. And so caricatured shapes, if the whole world isn't caricatured, that tends to work not as well. So this is the Dynaco gas station in Andy's neighborhood. You can see it's kind of a little brontosaurus in the logo. What we always wanted to do was kind of a 50s style leftover gas station in the neighborhood. And so we got a little bit of that. And we also wanted to get the really harsh fluorescent lighting. It's kind of got a blue tinge to it and just very harsh and very exposing. You can see things like little oil stains and tire tracks and oil can stand there. So if you look here too, some of the things we always struggled with were getting that cheesy cement rock texture on this trash can right here. If you look also inside the lobby of the gas station, you can see a few things like potato chips, and it's actually all there. So there's a lot of detail that sometimes you see in the background. Sometimes we wish we had spent more time on the things we do see than the stuff we really don't see. But the film changes so often and so fast in story that it's hard to keep up with that. Still, I think that it looks pretty good, and I'm pretty proud of it. We had a great art department on this film. This is Sid's room. And there's things like, I think there's, in the final film, there's underwear and socks hanging out of the dresser. And then if you look very carefully, you can see a waffle iron there with a baby smushed in it, little toy doll. And there's a really great poster up there, killing Paul Bunyan and his Blue Ox of Doom. The shooting target is actually one from layout artist Craig Good's office he's had hanging up. There, you can see how well he keeps his room locked. And there's just lots of junk laying around. We modeled a few things like cans and tapes and cups for other purposes in the film, and we needed it for set dressing, so we would sprinkle it throughout the room. One of the things that's really hard to do with the computer with a computer film is to really get the sense that it's a real space and not just kind of a cold environment. We were able to utilize little bits and pieces from all over the film and kind of cram it into Sid's room so that it looked like a mess.
How do you like that? He forgot us again.
Freeze! Woody, he's armed. Grab his sword before he kills us all.
Buzz, if I take his sword, he'll be naked.
Interesting alloy.
You wouldn't happen to have a cousin in Cleveland who's a bowling trophy, would you?
I'd like to thank the Academy for this award for best performance by a toy.
Of course, for you, that'd be best supporting toy.
Excuse me? Buzz, I had the leading role.
Technically, but I carried the picture. Ergo, you supported me.
Oh, yeah, Light Snack? Well, support this!
Hey, come on. Hey, give me that!
Look at me, I'm Woody. Howdy!
Give me back my hat!
Where's my horse? Howdy!
Hey, somebody's coming!
What a mess. That Lasseter's always forgetting his toys.
He forgot me, too.
Oh, no, honey, don't go there. Now, Woody and Buzz, they were going to do a big number here, but they look a little tired, so we're going to replace them with two real human beings performing the Oscar-nominated tune from Toy Story, You've Got a Friend in Me, and you do. It's composer Randy Newman and his friend, Lyle Lovett.
How long has he been gone?
9 minutes.
Come on, guys. Just because Andy's gone to school, that doesn't mean we have to put our lives on hold.
He's eating lunch now.
T minus 52 minutes.
Hey, guys! I think I see the bus! Let me see. Okay, kids are getting out. Wait, what day is this?
Tuesday!
Blast. Soccer practice.
I think we need a hobby.
Don't you get it? First comes the toy commercial, then that toy is right here in Andy's room!
Oh, look! A commercial for a new dinosaur toy. Hey, it glows in the dark!
Fish.
Calling Buzz Lightyear! The world's greatest toy just got better! New Cybersonic Buzz! Says over 15,000 word combinations!
A photon grenade! Hit the deck!
Battle Scar Buzz! With ultra damage!
Ooh, that'll leave a mark.
Skyrunner Buzz! It really flies!
Wow!
Buzz is light years better than before! Complete your collection! Today!
There's something to be said for the original.
And then something is yard sale.
Roadblock.
Important to the Space Ranger look is the Space Ranger attitude.
Eat laser, Zurg.
Now that's the right stuff.
Hey, buddy, look at me! I'm a Space Ranger!
Actually, he's just a space cadet. Keeps forgetting the secret handshake.
So, Mr. Lightyear, what do you think?
It takes a lot more than a goldfish bowl to be a Space Ranger, fella. Now, you're a Space Ranger. Congratulations.
Has anyone told them that this won't work?
I just don't have the heart. They'll never make hyperspeed with that much weight.
Has anyone told them that this won't work?
I just don't have the heart. There's not nearly enough fuel to get them to their home world.
Okay, steering contest, go!
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 good.
King me.
Woody! Hey! Woody! Over here! Woody, over here! Hey, Woody!
Oh, hi.
Who's winning? You know, in tournaments, there's usually a time limit for moving, but seeing as how this is a casual game between friends, I suppose International Checker Foundation rules can just be waived.
Bad move.
Tokens in, fellas. Here you go. Keep them coming. Congratulations. You just bought yourself a new planet.
Home. We have found a planet of our own.
No, fellas. That's not actually the Earth.
Do not take us for fools.
RC here has extremely low mileage.
Come on, I can tell you want to give it a spin.
I'll take it.
And the toy made it all the way from the clearance aisle to the cashier. The last words he heard were, "How did that get in the cart?" True story. And when they found him, his batteries were dead.
What are you afraid of? You don't even use batteries.
Oh, right.
Scariest part was, when the leveraged buyout fell through, the toy company was left with a big dark warehouse full of inventory!
Ooh, if I had bones, they'd be chilling.
Damn, I can't sleep.
Try counting sheep.
One, two, three. I don't see how this will help. For this, be honest. Hey fellas, which one of you was saving my place in line? Is this line for ticket holders or is it for ticket buyers?
Well, howdy ho, a western. Fine, then you pick the show.
Excellent, the Star Eaters.
Oh, please, not science fiction.
Fiction?
Hey, a dinosaur documentary. Maybe this one has a happy ending.
And there's the media. My turn.
Wall Street Report?
Oh, sure, on the outside I might be a pig, but on the inside, I'm all bank.
Okay, more to the left. Now grab his leg. No, his other leg. No, his other leg. Good.
Why doesn't Andy just get cable?
Anybody mind if I change?
Go!
No! Do not anger the TV!
The tube speaks to us. That Urkel slays me.
Hey! Know what I'm doing?
Yeah, breaking a TV remote.
No! I'm channel surfing! Get it? Channel surfing!
To infinity and beyond!
Blast!
A force field.
It's glass, Buzz.
This force field is unusually firm. Must find a way.
Glass, Buzz, not a force field. It's a television. You watch cartoons on it, unless you break it with your big, thick helmet head.
Stay back, friend. They've gotten to you, haven't they?
Oh!
What's on?
It's ABC. Did you know ABC was once part of another network until it was split off in an FCC-ordered divestiture? Of course, in the 80s, it merged with Cap Cities Communications, which ultimately led to it becoming, only recently, part of the Walt Disney Company.
Hmm. What's on?
Cartoons.
Ah, excellent.
You know, the history of cartoons, or animation, as I like to call it, can be traced back 20,000 years to certain programs. Did you know that as we calmly sit here, an intense debate rages within the paleontological community? Were dinosaurs hot-blooded, or were they cold-blooded? I'm overwrought with anxiety over this issue. I mean, what temperature was their blood? There's even a third camp that theorizes that larger dinosaurs may have been born hot-blooded, and after growing to a sufficient size, they suddenly switched to cold-blooded. Who am I supposed to believe? So the Jurassic gave way to the Cretaceous. For 72 million years, dinosaurs ruled the Earth.
And then?
Kaboom!
When did it get here?
Right after lunch.
Scanner readings are inconclusive.
Maybe Andy got peanut butter on your scanner.
There's only one way to find out what's in there.
I'll handle this. Oh, it's, happy snacky. Oh, no.
I come in peace.
Evil Emperor Zurg did this.
Actually, hey, Buzzy, I think it was one of your major fast food chains.
So, they just give you away with a burger and fries.
I came with chicken fingers.
Is this good for the economy?
We're doomed! Who's gonna buy what they can get for free?
So, what can you do there, little mister?
Well, if you pivot my head, my arm kind of makes this punching move.
Wow, I'm just a collectible.
And that's it?
Pretty much.
I think we're safe, guys. Is it me, or do you smell cheeseburgers? And this is the Toy Box. Well, that concludes your new toy orientation. Don't worry, little partner. I'm sure you'll fit in.
Yes! Look! Ooh! Ah! Ooh! Ah!
See? It's easy. Just takes a little practice.
Ooh!
That's good. That's a good start.
I know. It's not funny when clowns do it either.
Hey, where's my hat? My badge.
Howdy. Howdy.
Give me that. Sorry, legs. No nines. Go fish.
She lives for this.
We're clear.
Good play day, everybody.
So, how was your day, Boz?
If you don't mind, I'd rather not talk about it.
We'll be back after this break. Don't touch that dial, for goodness sake. Don't get mad, don't hold a grudge. We'll be back, so don't you budge. We'll be back with much more fun. Now don't you change that channel, son. Heidi, 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 ho. Break is over, here's the show. We'll be back after this break. Don't touch that dial, for goodness sake. We'll march in a small platoon. Let's march back to the cartoon. Break time's here, we have to say. Listen up, don't go away. Now we are back for some more. Big time action is in store. Don't touch your set, don't turn that dial. We'll be back in just a while. You stay with this way cool station. Now back to our animation.